Are your fluorescent tubes easy to replace with LED tubes? The answer to this question often comes down to if the ballast from the fluorescent fixture have to be removed. The reason you might be getting conflicting answers to this question is because there are actually four different types of LED tubes. Whether or not you need to remove the ballast actually depends on the type of LED tube you're installing. The four types are type A, B, C, and A+B. The easiest one to install is type A. It has an integrated driver with a ballast support, so it's usually compatible and operated on an existing ballast. So you don't have to remove the ballast to install a type A LED tube. To install a type B tube, you do have to remove the ballast, which is the job for a qualified electrician. That's because it's more dangerous. But type B tubes are more efficient than type A tubes. Type C tubes are the most efficient. They are a purely DC or direct current tube, and they operate on a remote driver rather than an integrated driver. And once the driver is installed, it can power several LED tubes throughout a fixture. It can also be integrated with dimming and control functionality. The downside is that ballasts also do have to be removed when replacing fluorescent tubes with type C LED tubes. The fourth type of LED tube is called type A+B. These LED tubes are, as you may have guessed, kind of a combination of type A and B LED tubes. This tube can work with or without an existing ballast most of the time. It's ideal for situations where you want to install a bunch of LEDs as quickly as possible, but you want to have a backup plan if it turns out that the ballast is not compatible with one of your LED tubes. As for which type you use, it really depends on your project and your budget, but we found a really great article that compares the four different types of LED tubes, and I'll just drop a link in the comments if you want to see that. Alright, thanks for watching, I really hope this helped, and let us know if it did. And if you want to see more content like this, feel free to subscribe to Electric Insights on YouTube. And I will see you in the next one.